out. We've got offensive tackle Dylan Cook, linebacker Jason Lewis. We'll start with some thoughts from Coach, and then we'll open it up to questions from the group. Coach, obviously a tough loss. Your initial thoughts on the team's performance today?
Sure, Tabes, thanks. first, congratulations to James Madison. It was a good win by them. They went out and I thought they played very well. They went out and kind of took the game and credit goes to them for playing a great football game and really holding us in check and making some plays against us and they just did a really nice job. They're well coached. They've got good players and they played a great game. So good job by them. I'm proud of my team as well. Really, really love our team. I think we have a great football team. The attrition through the season was really evident tonight. You know, we just didn't have enough left in the tank to go get this win. And it was a difficult situation. I thought our guys played their asses off and competed and played hard to the very end, as they always do, and unfortunately we didn't get the win.
Questions for the group?
Bobby, the two long touchdowns in the first half, can you just take us through those plays? Is anything that they hit in particular that caught you guys off guard?
No, they just executed. Giving up the big play has not been our Achilles heel this year, and we gave up three big plays in this game, and that was probably really the difference in the game. So good job by them making them. They made plays, and we didn't.
And then when camp goes down, what's the process like to the decision-making to get from Chris Brown to Robbie Patterson in the second half?
We start out trying to get first downs and then hopefully finish some drives and get some points. We didn't do a very good job of that. And then we ended up talking it over at halftime, decided Robbie gave us the best chance to score points and gave us the best chance to win. And thought he did an admirable job competing in there.
Jace, right after Cam went down, you had the big hit to force the fumble. So did you feel like just as a defense you guys needed to make a play right there?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like that was a pretty good play after Cam went down, and it was good for our defense to get a turnover and get our offense back on the field with a short field like that. So
Bobby, just talk about your team's resiliency. The injuries have been an issue all year, and they just kind of came to a head today. Just how these guys kept fighting against James Madison today.
Yeah, Kyle, we've got a really competitive group, and you get to the point where we've got a pretty young team to start with, and when you start losing guys, you get younger and younger, and eventually, against this level of competition, that takes its toll. It's you play a really good opponent. It's hard for guys that haven't played much or that youthful to come in and play.
And then Dylan, Sammy got hurt obviously on the first drive, how did the offense, I guess, try to balance with him, with losing him? Such a key player, but he goes out right away. How did you guys kind of weather that storm as well as you could?
We really kind of just took it upon the offensive line and just kind of told each other we got to be able to run the ball efficiently and get some yards. And we did towards the end, but just not good enough.
In that second half, too, with Robbie coming in, your thoughts on the way he played and it seems toward the very end he was, doing everything he could to try to keep you guys in it.
Outstanding play by Robbie Patterson. He came in with not a lot of reps on the season and came in and led the offense on two pretty good drives. Just couldn't close them out, but kudos to him.
Dylan, you guys got into James Madison territory, I think, five times in the first two and a half quarters. Couldn't finish the drives. What did anything change when James Madison got closer down to the red zone defensively?
Defensively?
Was on defense. Did they change anything defensively to kind of buckle down?
Not really. They were kind of doing the same stuff. Like Coach Alex said, that's a good team over there, good defense. They just knew how to bend but not break.
How tough is it when you kind of see two of your senior leaders on the team and they have to go out early and they're sitting on the sidelines? I imagine that's just kind of you know, difficult to watch?
Everything's tough in this program. We're kind of used to adversity, and we take that on as a challenge with a smile on our face because we look at it as another chance to step up and show who we are.
Bobby and Jace, the running back number five, Palmer, just what made him so hard to bring down today?
I'll start and you can follow up. I mean, I thought they played, I thought that Madison played well up front. You know, that's where it starts. And they played well up front. They've got a good offensive line, and they did a good job.
Yeah, I mean, they have really good running backs, and like Coach Alex said, they have a really good O-line that got some push for their running backs, and then they made some plays.
Jace Dillon mentioned just so many things being kind of tough this year, but you guys kind of embracing that. So how are you able to just have the effort you guys did, especially defensively, all season long?
Yeah, I mean, I think when you come to a place like Montana, you learn very quickly that that's instilled with you in you, and if you don't have that within you, you won't last long in this program. And I think that's a testament to every player that you saw out there today. And I think it's a pretty special thing Montana has going for them right now.
Bobby, just, you know, this season as a whole, just, you know, your thoughts on it. It's obviously, you know, it ended so quickly, but, you know, they had the Washington win to start it, you know, getting back at Eastern last week, beating the Bobcats. Just, you know, how would you kind of sum up what's been a, you know, pretty special year for you guys?
Yeah, I really love this team. I think this is a great football team. Like I said, we didn't have enough in the tank tonight to get it done, but you know, this is a special football team. They're really good. A lot of big wins. You know, anytime you're winning 10 games, it's a fine year, and we're back in business where we're competing for it every year now. And I think there's great that we're a young team. Great things moving forward. So we'll digest this one and the season a little bit. Don't want to push on to next year too soon because, as you mentioned, there were so many great things this fall and so much. It's just fun to see the joy back in Grizz Nation.
And for both Jace and Dillon, you know, a couple of guys who were walk-ons, you guys have had, you know, just different trajectories for your careers to get to this point. Just, you know, kind of sum up what it's been like playing for this program and what this year was like for both of you.
Yeah, Montana's a special place, like I said. I mean, starting from the coaches down, the players, I mean, I love, I wouldn't want to be anywhere else. And from where I started to where I am now, I mean, it's kind of surreal sitting here knowing my career's done, but I can't wait to come back and watch these guys go next year. And I mean, it's been a great year for us.
Yeah. You can't beat it, man. Like I'm just grateful and blessed that Coach Alk took a chance on me and allowed me to come here and give my all and earn a spot. And Grizz Nation, man, you can't beat it.
For all three of you guys, what are you going to remember the most about this senior class? And how would you describe the impact this group has had on getting Grizz football back to where you envisioned it?
Well, I think the thing I remember is not just Saturdays, the work put in, the effort level, the belief that's was developed, and you know, as a group, they really didn't think they could be beat. I think that confidence level permeated the young guys on the team when they walked in the door, and that came from our senior group. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. We take these?
Yeah.